ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ हिस्ट्री क्लास 10 चैप्टर 1 पार्ट 8 द राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी रेड अबाउट फ्यू वर्ड्स रिलेटेड टू चैप्टर 1 एंड द फिगर्स गिवन इन द चैप्टर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कैरी फॉरवर्ड द न्यू वर्ड्स गिवन इन द चैप्टर as well as the figures and the important sources of study for chapter 1. Ethnic. Ethnic relates to a common racial, tribal or cultural origin or background that a community identifies with or claims. Allegory. When an abstract idea, for instance, greed, envy, freedom, liberty, is expressed through a person or a thing. An allegorical story has two meanings, one literal and one symbolic. Learn the terms as well as the description of it. This is important for one mark question. Now let us see this figure, figure 10. Imagine you were a citizen of Frankfurt in March 1848 and were present during the proceedings of the parliament. How would you, as a man seated in the Hall of Deputies and as a woman observing from the galleries, relate to the banner of Germania hanging from the ceiling? This clear gives us the idea about the female allegory as the German nation, as attributed by the deputies in the parliament. Now, A, as a man seated in the Hall of Deputies, I would consider the banner of Germania to have come true. That means the German unification, the process of German unification has come true. And B, as a woman observing from the galleries, I would consider the banner of Germania to be a partial representation of liberal nationalist ideas, that is the idea of the people, those who are craving for their own nation and national identity. This is important for one mark question. Now, this picture given over here in figure 15, Garibaldi helping King Victor Emmanuel II of Sardinia Piedmont to pull on the boot named Italy. This is in regard to the Italian unification, a caricature by English caricaturist of 1859. Now the artist has portrayed Garibaldi as holding on to the base of the boot so that the King of Sardinia Piedmont can enter it from the top. Look at the map of Italy once more. What statement is this caricature making? According to the picture, the boots symbolize the kingdom of two Sicilies that lied in the southern Italy. Garibaldi is the person who is responsible for the unification of Italy. Garibaldi, through his ideas and his techniques and his effort, had won the two Sicilies and later handed over them to King of Sardinia Piedmont, who was proclaimed the King of United Italy. Now the picture signifies the unification, the process of unification of Italy and the role played by Garibaldi in it. Now, let us move to the source C. How were liberty and equality for women be defined. The liberal politician Karl Welker, an elected member of the Frankfurt Parliament, expressed the following views. Nature has created men and women to carry out different functions. Man, the stronger, the bolder, and freer of the two, has been designated as protector of family, its provider, meant for public tasks in domain of law, production, defense. Woman, the weaker, dependent, and timid, requires the protection of man. Her sphere is the home, the care of the children, the nurturing of the family. Do we require any further proof that given such differences? Equality between the sexes would only endanger harmony and destroy the dignity of the family. Louis Otto Peters was a political activist who founded a women's journal and subsequently a feminist political association. The first issue of her newspaper carried the following editorial. Let us ask how many men possessed by thoughts of living and dying for the sake of liberty would be prepared to fight for the freedom of the entire people, of all human beings? When asked this question, they would all too easily respond with a yes. Though their untiring efforts are intended for the benefit of only one half of the humanity, that is men. But liberty is indivisible. Free men therefore must not tolerate to be surrounded by the unfree. An anonymous reader of the same newspaper sent the following letter to editor on 25th June 1850. It is indeed ridiculous and unreasonable to deny women political rights, even though they enjoy the right to property which they make use of. They perform functions and assume responsibilities without, however, getting the benefits that accrue to men for the same. Why this injustice? Is it not a disgrace that even the stupidest cattle herder possesses the right to vote simply because he is a man? Whereas highly talented women owning considerable property are excluded from this right, even though they contribute so much to the maintenance of the state. So this source talks about the feminist movement and the propounded political thinkers, those who have initiated the support for the women's to their political rights and the injustice meted out to the women in the society. According to the liberal nationalist, liberty is only meant for the men. They were against the universal adult franchise. This we have already read in our class 9 when we have read about the socialism and the political theory after the French Revolution, that women's even after the French Revolution and have French being acquired the name and fame as a nation, the women's long after that struggled to get the political rights recognized to them. So this source talks about the feminist movement and the women's rights for their political rights to vote and equality in the nation. Now, another activity. With the help of the chart in box 3, identify the attributes of weeds germania and interpret the symbolic meaning of the painting in an earlier allegorical rendering of 1836. Wheat had portrayed the Kaiser's crown at the place where he has now located the broken chain. Explain the significance of this change. The painting of Germania by Philip Wieth symbolizes that German nation has emerged. It is the beginning of new era in which the liberal nationalist attitude would prevail. Now, there are some attributes and the significance given over here. This is the description of the box 3, the painting done by Wieth, and the significance of the objects that is being placed in the figure. The broken chain, it symbolizes the act of becoming free, and breastplate with eagle, this talks about the strength, symbol of German strength. Crown of oak leaves, this talks about the liberty and the heroism. This talks about the liberty and the heroism. Sword, this talks about the readiness to fight for the cause of nation by the German people. Olive branch around the sword, willingness to make peace. Black, red and gold tricolor, flag of the liberal nationalist in 1848, banned by the dukes of the German state. This flag was created by the German freedom fighters for the cause of nation state, emergence of the nation state in Germany, as Germany. Now, rays of the rising sun, beginning of a new era and end of the monarchical regime. These are the symbols that talks about the new beginning. The new nation has enormous strength and is ready to make war or establish peace with its neighbors. The nation of Germany is also free from the clutches of the autocratic or the monarchical dominance. Germania is wearing an oak leaf crown, which symbolizes heroism. The change in Wieth's earlier portrait of Germania, where crown was placed at the place of broken chains, symbolizes that the nation is free from the autocratic monarchical rule, and Germany have been recognized as a free nation. This is very important for your study of chapter 1 to understand about the unification movement in Germany. Now, describe what you see in figure 17. Figure 17, Germania. The figure drawn by Philip Wieth in 1848. The artist prepared the painting of Germania on a cotton banner, as it was meant to hang from the ceiling of Church of St. Paul, where the Frankfurt Parliament was convened in March 1848. Now, the question arises, what historical events could Hübner be referring to in this allegorical vision of nation? Now, describe what you see in the figure. In the figure by Julius Hübner, Germania had fallen down in the front of Kaiser's crown and stick. This symbolizes that National Assembly of the All Germans that began at the Church of St. Paul as Frankfurt Parliament had failed. This was the earlier picture we are talking about. Now, this in present which we are talking about is the figure 17. This is the picture by Philip Wieth. Now, in the chapter only, previously it was the figure of Germania fallen at the feet of the monarch. That symbolizes that, that is the figure by Julius Hübner. In that, it was the attempt being failed to being recognized as a German nation. Now, this figure symbolizes. Now, what is the vision to in this allegorical vision of the nation? The crown and the stick the crown and the stick symbolized that the Frankfurt Parliament was disbanded by the monarch and military. Now this talks about the freedom of the people of Germany from the clutches of monarchical regime. In the next upcoming video, we will be talking about part 5, picture reading and source based analysis of chapter 2. Om Namah Shivaya.